our starting lineups. We'll look at the matchups here and who we'll see for our starting five for both teams. Okay, first for the Bulls, Rajon Rondo is out there with Jimmy Butler. And playing at the center position, one of the Lopez twins out of Stanford, 7-foot banger Robin Lopez. Then there's Dunleavy, and it's Gibson in at the four spot. And for New York, Derrick Rose is out there with a flounder. And down low, the two-time NCAA champion at Florida, the 6'11 tornado of energy and effort, it's the big man Joakim Noah. Then it's Anthony, and it's Porzingis in at the power forward.
And really, the Bulls weathered a lot of injuries last season and still had a good showing in the East. Came away with the 3 seed when many thought they would sink down after missing so many games from key players.
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg with Doris Burke reporting from the sideline. And so off the tip, it's New York. Back to Rose. Pass to Porzingis. New York moving the ball around. And a follow kicks to Rose. Porzingis. And the Bulls did end up with the 3rd seed in the East, 33 of their 50 wins last year, Clark, coming in the Eastern Conference.
But it wasn't an even distribution of those wins for the Bulls. Against their own division in the Southeast, they played 500 basketball. They got their good in-conference record from feasting on the Atlantic teams, taking 16 wins in 18 games against that division.
And he makes the first.
And guys, Porzingis was almost a rookie last season, but he opted to pull out of the early entry and wait a year for this past summer's draft. Seems to have worked out for him as far as how his draft stock has changed.
Both good from the line that time. Greg, you're right with Porzingis. It made sense for him to wait one more year. Clark has a lot to learn, but still comes over, as a much talked about player, a much better player than had he declared last season.
I agree with you, yet he'll still need time to develop, but all the ingredients are there. He's got a chance to be a really good player.
Yeah, the Latvian had a great shot for his height, and there'll be an interesting stretch four in the NBA.
Good call.
And so here is New York. About 1 minute into the first quarter. Noah with a screen on Rondo. And it's Rose penetrating. And Rondo sends it back. Rose gets the bucket. Here's Rondo. Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What'd you find out, DB?
He said that their defensive focus, no surprise, will be trying to keep Derrick Rose out of the lane. He added, you know he's come a long way as an outside shooter, but he's a pick-your-poison type of player. We can't let him get into the paint. Makes sense, Kevin.
Thanks, Doris. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone. Butler, he's guarded by Aflalo. Shot clock at 6. And he gets it to go. On defense, the Bulls. Outside, Rose. Pass to Porzingis. Outside, Anthony. Unloads from 13. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. We'll shoot one more at the free throw line.
And Steve, near the bucket, he's one of the best finishers around. I mean, he does a great job of using his strong body to fight through contact and get to the rack.
I mean, the Knicks were bad last year, and it became evident early on. As the season grew older, more and more of their national coverage games were being pulled.
For the Knicks, losing a lot of nationally televised games, too. It seemed like every time they were around, they were losing. It might have been a blessing in disguise.
Well, I hope they look at it in a positive vein. It did give them a chance to focus on player development there in New York. Also allowed them to shut down Melo for the season.
Rondo drives in, and they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Rondo against Rose. He passes to Porzingis. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Porzingis has got 5 points so far. Bulls trail by 5. Outside Rondo. Pass to Butler. Back to Rondo. Lopez, a screen on Rose. Just 5 to shoot. Rondo drives in. And he lays it straight in. Rondo's got his second basket of the game.
I tell you what, the defenders didn't even get a sniff of him on that move to the hoop.
Rose passes to a flower. Some solid defense from Butler.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Rondo with it, and Rose picks him up defensively. And that one's good. 6 points for Rajon Rondo.
And early on, they've been nearly perfect from the floor. Just the one miss here on their first 5 attempts.
Anthony kicks to a follow. Noah with a screen for a follow. And Anthony gets it to go.
How about that screen by Noah?
Bulls trail by 3. Now Rondo. He has 6. The finger roll finish at the bucket. Rondo's got 8 points.
And at 4 or 5 now, a nice start. I mean, he looks ready to make an impact offensively. So far, so good.
Anthony drives in. The kick out to Rose. That one falls, coming off Anthony's feet. He's got 5.
Just a little confusion among the D as to who was supposed to be on it.
Rondo dishes to Lopez. Outside Butler. He kicks to Rondo. 4 on the clock. Chicago needs to get off a shot here. And a fast break now for the Knicks. Anthony leading the charge. Gibson with the steal. Outside Butler. Oh, that's blocked. Here's the screen. It's Anthony with the drive. Outside Rose. The pass to Porzingis. For 3. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
That's far too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
3 of their last 5 makes come from beyond the arc. The defense has to react quickly.
And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. Last season ended with the Knicks pretty much packing it in, but Clark, it didn't start out that way.
You know what? Not at all. I mean, the Knicks were picked by many, Kevin, to be a playoff team last season. Clearly, things did not go as planned.
Mirotić has checked in for Chicago. Bulls trail by 7. Outside Rondo. Gibson setting a pick for Rondo. And they double up Rondo. Dunleavy kicks to Butler. He dishes it to Mirotić. Clock at 4. No good off the back of the rim.
And it became clear, thinking about the Knicks again. I mean, it made sense for a team with injuries and being in disarray on the floor to just battle for that lottery.
They set the pick. Outside Rose. Shoots. And there's another one for the Knicks.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offensively.
Rondo, he's covered by Rose. Rondo passes to Butler. And again, no good by Chicago.
You know, kind of packing it in for the sake of being better in the future can possibly work in New York for a year or two, but not longer than that. The media will eat you up there if you don't start making some progress towards winning pleasing basketball.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
So Chicago going with an almost entirely new grouping. Bulls trail by 11. Now here's Calderon. Back to Miritic. That falls. Nice feed this time from Jose Calderon. Miritic has got himself on the board with three there. There's Galloway. Vujicic kicks to Thomas. Fires the three. The rebound by Gibson. The Bulls have gone 6-10 from the field in this ballgame. Valentine passes to Miritic. Speedy. Gibson setting a pick for Calderon. Some nice ball movement by the Bulls. Miritic's shot is off. New York leading by 8. There's the screen.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
.158 left in the first quarter. Now Vujicic feeds it to Galloway.
And despite that miss, a strong start for them offensively.
Yeah, they're scoring with confidence, Greg, making them count in the early going here.
And guys, what a strange rookie campaign for Dougie McBuckets. I mean, he entered the draft as a polished sharpshooter. The Bulls traded up in the first round to get him, and he ended up playing 9 minutes a game over the course of last season.
The Knicks have gotten 8 of their 13 shots to find the bottom of the bucket. Vujicic dishes to Galloway. The feed now to Serafin. Kicks it to Galloway. Here's Vujicic. A three-pointer off the mark.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start.
Yeah, the half-and-half balls are going their way, and that's really a function of effort and intensity. You know, the ball doesn't discriminate. Whoever goes and gets it, that's who owns it.
Valentine passes to Miritic. Nikola Miritic, drafted as a late first-rounder, Clark, back in 2011. The Spanish star finally made his rookie debut in the NBA last season, and it was worth the wait.
It sure was, Kevin. I mean, once he started to get consistent PT, I mean, he was remarkable. Can run like the wind for a big guy, not that strong, but more aggressive than you'd think.
First free throw is good. Tony Snell's checked in for Taj Gibson. So Miritic nails both of them.
We're seeing today what makes him one of the best free throw shooters among the league's big men. Beautiful stroke.
Here's the dish to Vujicic. He feeds it to Galloway. Passes it to Thomas. He kicks it to Serafin. They need this one. They get the rebound. Pass to Vujicic. Dishes it to Galloway. Feeds to Vujicic. Pass to Galloway. Kicks it to Vujicic. And it's off from three-point range. Bulls trail by 6. And the pass to Miritic. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Brooks. And that's now 7 points for Nikola Miritic. Galloway kicks to Vujicic. This one for 3. What a play. Simply drains it in at the buzzer.
And money to end the quarter there with the triple.
They knew exactly what they wanted to do right there, Greg, and the timing was right on time.
And we reached the end of the first quarter. Knicks lead by 7. And the second quarter will get underway just after this short break. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Knicks?
I tell you what, the scoring has come in threes for the most part here so far.
Every time down the floor, it seems they're knocking down the triple.
The Bulls shooting it really well, 54% from the floor. And here is Brooks.
I got the help, help side.
He passes to Lopez. Brooks, six on the shot clock. There's Mirotić. Back to Brooks. He dishes it to Snell. Buries it from three-point range. Snell's got the opening basket here in the second quarter for Chicago.
That's a layup for him. He's just too open.
Thomas a screen. There's Galloway. Back to Williams. Launches it. Kept alive by New York. Good. And the Knicks lead by six.
How about the perseverance there? The extra effort on that offensive glass.
Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. Back to Mirotić. Plenty of space. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Mirotić has got nine.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Mirotić's shot is off.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range. And injuries, once again, were a central theme of the Bulls' season last year. Losing Rose was one thing, but then having Jimmy Butler lose a lot of time put them in such a tough spot.
Here's Galloway. Puts the lead pass in front of him. Calderon against Williams. Snell kicks to Brooks. And the Bulls, another three. And for the Bulls, an injury is a lot of teams plan for these type of things. There's only so much Clarke can do to mitigate losing your starting backcourt.
But I tell you, great respect and admiration for the Bulls for how they fought through the difficulty. I mean, their front court did what they could. The injuries, once again, I thought turned the Bulls from championship contenders to just a playoff team.
Grant, he's checked in for the Bulls. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. They set the screen. Now the feed to Vujicic. It's hauled in by the Bulls. Mirotić has got three rebounds now in this one.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had early.
Now here's Brooks. Snell, he's guarded by Williams. Lock at six. Lopez dishes to Snell. And the Bulls, another three.
Great outside shooting fueling this run.
And the D is getting bombarded. They haven't been able to slow them down the least bit.
There's Galloway. The dish to Vujicic. He kicks it to Galloway. Passes it to Porzingis. And the Knicks miss again. Now the Bulls with it. They're on an 11-2 run. Grant the pass to Mirotić. And the call will be against Langston Galloway. That's his first foul. Bulls making a switch here. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played. Grant against Rose. It's off his leg. And it's being called a kickball. Here's Dunleavy. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. Lopez kicks to Mirotić. Down to five on the shot clock. Dunleavy dishes to Miritich. At three off the mark. For New York, they've gotten off to a rough start here in the second quarter, going just 1 for 5. Outside Rose. Noah with a screen on Grant. Rose. And he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick. Rose has got 9.
Rose can really turn it on at times.
Miritich sets the screen for Grant. He feeds it to Brooks. And he sinks the shot coming off the strong pick. Brooks has got his second bucket of the game to go.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
And it's something we haven't seen much of at the opposite end of the floor.
Watching Mike Dunleavy Jr., he's simply the mark of consistency. We know he's in his mid-30s, but you know exactly what you're going to get out of him every season. I think Tom Thibodeau, last year's Chicago coach, really admired that and loved it.
It's so funny watching Mike Dunleavy Jr. play. I remember when his dad coached me when I was with Portland.
Oh my gosh.
He was a little kid running around, and all of a sudden he's become this great NBA player. But you're right, though. He's made himself into a valuable asset in terms of the role he's been given for the Bulls.
And he gets it to go. Now it's a 6-point Bulls lead.
And finally, it looks like he's gotten his feet under him in terms of his offense.
Rose with the ball. He's got 9. A follow outside. And it's Rose penetrating. New York needs to get off a shot. Porzingis can't hit.
Talking about Dunleavy, boy, I tell you, he was playing at a high level already by his second season in the league. Practically every statistic across the board matches up since then. And that's over a decade later.
Now, here's Grant. Pass to Brooks. Let's the three fly. Can't hit. Knicks trail by 6. And it's Rose penetrating. And he converts the layup. Rose has got 11.
And getting back to Dunleavy's consistency here in his later years, he's one of those guys who has really ramped up the nutrition. He's hitting the weight room. I could make the case that he was a tougher, better player last year, especially on defense, than at any other time in his career.
And fellas, in this quarter, he's improved on what was already a very good performance in period number 1.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Noah, the pass to a follow. Shoots a fader. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Here's Chicago. They're on a 20-6 run. Pass to Dunleavy. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. New York's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Outside Rose. A follow outside. From the stripe. That's good on the jump shot.
That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
Chicago leading by 5. Miritich the screen. Brooks kicks to Miritich. And Brooks, here we go. Miritich, 6 to shoot. Lopez inside, covered by Noah. Miritich's shot is off. The Knicks shooting 36% in the second quarter. They really haven't found their rhythm yet offensively here. A follow, the pass to Porzingis. Some nice passing by New York here. The shot by Williams, no good. Bulls have had a great rebounding team for a long time now. Last season was no different.
Yeah, so many categories to measure how well a team rebounds. The Bulls were in the top 3 in almost all of them.
As for the Bulls in rebounding, I mean, they were 2nd in the league in winning contested rebounds. That's another data analytics stat for you folks. 2nd overall in total rebounds, too.
Here's what Chicago's going with right now. Taj Gibson's checked in for Lopez. And it's Doug McDermott in for Mirotić.
And with the big men the Bulls have, it's easy to see why they rebound so well. But make no mistake, guards and bigs alike rebound well on this Bulls team.
Now here's Aflalo. Back to Rose. It's Carmelo Anthony on the wing. And it's out of bounds for the Knicks as New York retains possession.
Risky pass in a situation like that. Very lucky that wasn't a steal.
Fortunate to get it through. I thought he was headed the other way with that one.
104 left to play in the first half. Here's O'Quinn. Rajon Rondo with the rebound. The Bulls leading by 8. McDermott dishes to Rondo. Outside Butler. Back to Rondo. Feeds it to McDermott. 5 to shoot. Dunleavy. He's guarded by Aflalo. The shot. And the shot is long.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
23 seconds left in the second quarter. On the wing. That's good. 13 points for Derrick Rose.
And despite the hot start from beyond, they've gotten away from shooting the triple.
And trailing in this game, now is not the time to start playing conservatively. I mean, if you've got an open look from deep, let it go. I mean, you've got to play freely and with confidence.
Here's Gibson. Misses off the right iron.
Well, he gets it in close, but you have to credit that stifling defense for forcing the miss.
Exactly, Greg. I mean, defense like that really increases the degree of difficulty on that shot by a large amount.
And we've reached halftime in this one. It's Chicago. They're up by 6. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball. And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. You know, Mirotić has been exceptional here, guys.
And he just went off in those first two quarters, guys. He's capable of doing that on a consistent basis as well. So we might see some changes from a defensive standpoint as they try to disrupt his rhythm in the second half.
You know, guys, I think you've got to make some sort of change. I mean, they can't let him continue to torch him up like he has been. And I don't think you can look past what a fearless player he is, too, guys. I mean, just look at all the charges he takes.
It was a trade that seemingly had been talked about for several years. Finally, last season, Boston shipping out Rajon Rondo to the Dallas Mavericks, Clark, halfway through the season.
Yeah, and it seemed to me to be a trade that actually helped both teams.
Now here's Rondo. Lopez, a screen on Anthony. Follow against Rondo. Shoots it, and he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Outside Anthony. Noah with a screen for Anthony. Anthony drawing the double team. Rose kicks to Anthony. Here's Porzingis. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. Porzingis has got 11 points.
He has such a sweet three-point stroke there, and it can really open things up inside because as good as he shoots it, it forces the opposing bigs to have to step out on the perimeter.
Now here's Butler. Lopez sets a screen for Rondo. Noah with the block. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Bulls will retain possession. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Knicks trail by 7. And pushing it up, here's New York. Rose can't hit.
And you can see the defender's afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Now, here's Butler. The drive by Rondo. Shot clock at 6. Count the bucket. Rondo's got 4 points in the quarter.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
New York calls timeout. Rondo against Rose. Anthony, the pass to Rose. Let's it go from 14. That's in there. Anthony with the assist. 15 points for Derrick Rose. Chicago calls timeout. Carmelo Anthony, the third pick overall in the 2003 NBA draft, was in some pretty good company at the top of that one, as I recall.
I mean, you had LeBron going one, and of course, Darko Milicic was number two on that list. But how about D-Wade at 4? A little bit of a surprise. Chris Bosh, you know, all those guys, with the exception of Melo, have ranked.
Mm-hmm. Here's Rondo following the score by Derrick Rose. Outside Gibson. Rondo. Lock at 6. Right side Rondo. And that one's good. Rondo's got 14 points.
And back to Melo's top 5 draft mates in 2003, all having rings. You can't choose the team you play for as a rookie. Melo simply hasn't been surrounded by that much talent. That's why it was somewhat surprising that he re-signed with the rebuilding Knicks team last season.
Shot's good.
And the defense just gets caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass.
Now here's Rondo. He's got 14. Rondo is doubled. They get a hand on it. It's stolen by Rose. And now the Knicks on the break. Anthony leading the charge. And he gets it to go. Now just a 5-point Chicago lead.
And he's really shot the ball well. But it hasn't been contagious. And guys, talking about Melo, I mean, he's faced some difficult injuries here of late. That puts all the more pressure on him to win a ring as soon as possible. No way does he want to retire without that chance.
Just 4 to shoot. Here's Rondo. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Rondo's got 16. New York's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Outside Anthony. Anthony right side.
Come get it, come get it.
Here's Porzingis, defended by Gibson. Here's Rose. That one off the back iron and out. The Bulls leading by 7. Dunleavy kicks the butt. And that one's good.
I love how he establishes his post position inside before he converts.
The Knicks have gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. A follow right side. This is DeCarmelo. Outside Rose. That is good. Rose has got 6 here in this quarter.
Really hard to find fault with anything he's doing this quarter, at least at the offensive end.
Now here's Rondo. 16 points for him. Here's Gibson. And that one comes up a bit short. Knicks trail by 7. Well, nobody said, Greg, being in the NBA was for the faint of heart. The Knicks in a few short years have gone from a playoff team unfortunately, to the worst team in the NBA.
Hard to fathom, Kevin, that the Knicks did enter last season with playoff aspirations, but that quickly vanished. They were just completely overmatched and overwhelmed.
And so he hits the technical free throw.
You know, the Knicks made the playoffs every season between 1988 and 2001. It's kind of strange now to see the Knicks struggle to get into the playoffs so often. Only three trips in the playoffs the last 10 seasons.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Tony Snell's checked in for Lopez. Calderon comes in for Mike Dunleavy. And Speedy subbed in for Rajon Rondo. And so here is Chicago. After Aaron Aflalo getting his shot to go from deep. Butler dishes to Snell. Trying to come right back with a three of his own. But it's no good.
And listen, the pressure is always on the Knicks to make the playoffs just because of where the team is. Being in New York can have its advantages, but it comes with expectations that your team will be in the postseason.
Kicks to Calderon. Here's the pass to Valentine. He dishes it to Gibson. Tries a three. But they'll get another chance. Calderon kicks to Butt. The feet to Snell. He passes to Calderon. The dish to Butler. He kicks to Snell. The offensive rebound. And that one's good. Knicks trail by five. Anthony kicks to Galloway. Back to Anthony. Passes to Galloway. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Well, I know last year the Knicks seemed to me to be very passive offensively, and that can sometimes be the case when you're trying to learn the triangle offense, but they never seem to attack the rim at all.
First one falls for him. Greg, as you mentioned, the Knicks very shy at going to the rim last year. Really could have used that dynamic among a lot of things to their game.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I mean, think about this. The Knicks were last in the league in drives per game as a team. So they struggled shooting when they did attack the rim, only 42%. So those areas have to improve if this team wants to become competitive.
Six on the shot clock. Mirotic's shot is off. New York's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. For the tie, Galloway, no good.
Boy, even though he missed, you can't give up that kind of a look very often.
Better to be lucky than good sometimes. Fortunately, they didn't get burned on that one.
The drive by Anthony. He feeds it to Rose. Pass to Galloway. Dishes it to Serafin. Good D by Lopez.
Yeah, but you have to love that tough interior defense.
And, Greg, that's exactly what he gives you. I mean, he's constantly making his presence felt around the rim.
Mirotić, the pass to Lopez. He's against Serafin. Lopez dishes to Mirotić. Good on the baseline, Jay. Mirotić has got 16. Knicks trail by five. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
Anthony kicks to Galloway. Pass to Rose. Good.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the three-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
36 seconds left in the third. Calderon up top. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Drops in the layup for two. And the Bulls lead by five.
And every once in a while, he'll show up and give you some great moves around the hoop.
Now Anthony feeds to Galloway from the baseline. That one goes. Count it. Galloway has got 4 points this quarter. Here's Speedy.
Oh, he knocks it in, a beautiful buzzer beater.
Just in time.
Wow, what a miracle heave to finish off the quarter. How'd he get that one to go?
I don't know, but I think that's a 2% shot. He'd make 2 out of 100 of those.
Welcome back as we get rolling once more. The fourth quarter right ahead in what's been a very well-contested game. And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Bulls.
Well, I got to say, one thing that stuck out all game is the consistent penetration they've got.
Yeah, and it doesn't hurt to be on fire from beyond. They have been really good from the three-point line.
Dunleavy, the pass to Rondo. Shot clock at 6. And it's going to be a 3-second call. Bulls making a switch here. Lopez is checked in. Knicks trail by 6. Anthony kicks to Aflalo. The pass to Rose. He dishes it to O'Quinn. Lock at 6. Anthony, defended by Dunleavy. Releases. Here's O'Quinn. That's good. O'Quinn's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the Knicks. Chicago leading by 4. And here's Rondo. Kicks to Butler. Back to Rondo. There's the feed to Butler. Tires the 3. And it's O'Quinn with the rebound. O'Quinn's got 3 rebounds now in this one. And it's Rose penetrating. There's the dish to Noah. Outside Rose. Off the screen. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
And that's such solid, fundamental basketball on display right there, guys.
You talk about it all the time, Greg. Yeah, great use of the pick to set up a dunk.
And guys, it was a terrific understanding between teammates that made that possible. They really did read each other well there.
Rondo against Rose. Rondo kicks the butt. Three-pointer. And he gets it to go. And the Bulls lead by 5.
These defenders had better start closing out on those shooters.
That's 2 in a row, and we call that a streak.
New York calls timeout. For a franchise that had so much success under his tenure, there was sure a lot of friction with Tom Thibodeau, and the Bulls front office surprised a lot of people, I know, including yourself.
Yeah, you know, it's not something that you see often, a winning coach at odds with his GM and president. With how often their differences came up, though, you knew something was afoot.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Hi, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Derek Fisher was giving to his team. He let his players know that they've got to do a better job on defense. He said, they're scoring any way they want. We've got to show some pride here. Let's make a stand defensively, get us stops, and get on a run of our own. Do they have it in them, Kevin?
Back to Mirotić.
And with Thibs, he did end up getting fired from the Bulls this past season. Some saw it coming, but still, I think surprising given the level of success he had. His imprint is all over this Bulls team and the way they approach the game.
Chicago leading. Outside Butler, and they double up Butler. And Mirotić kicks to Butler. Outside Rondo, 6 to shoot. He passes it to Lopez, and he gets it to go.
And when you look at how Thibs got fired, I mean, there are a lot of reasons why a coach can be let go. I mean, he didn't have any performance issues, but apparently clashed in some form or fashion with the front office. Sometimes that's all it takes to be asked to go somewhere else.
The open shot, Rhodes. A follow outside. He kicks it to Rhodes. Passes it to Carmelo, and there's the foul. It'll go on Nikola Mirotic. That is his first foul of the game.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
Porzingis, he's checked in for New York. The kick out to Rose. That doesn't go either for Rose.
He's still looking for his first three-pointer of the second half after making just one in the first.
Mirotic's shot is off. Knicks trail by three. Porzingis passes to Rose. Pass to Porzingis to tie it up. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time.
And the road back into this game wasn't a short one, but they've managed to make it all the way back and tie this thing up.
And, Greg, I've got to admit to you, I mean, I did not think they were going to get all the way back. I thought they were done. They've shown some serious resilience and character to battle this far back.
Mike Dunleavy, he's checked in for Mirotic. Chicago's gone outside a lot tonight, 17 times, in fact. 7 of 17. Rondo dishes to Gibson. Back to Rondo. Banked in off the glass. And the Bulls lead by two.
And his stroke has been dead on from the outside. I mean, inside, outside. It just doesn't matter.
Outside Rose. Offside Rose steps back and fires. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Rose has got 14 points now in the second half. Chicago's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Rose against Rondo. He feeds it to Butler. Leaps for it. Shot clock at 6. And so it looks like the Bulls will retain possession here. And here are the Bulls now. Shot clock at 3. Sinks that one from the post. Butler's got 5 points in the quarter.
There's been a change in his game compared to what we saw in the first half. I mean, he's scoring with a lot of confidence now.
Aflalo kicks to Rose. Back to Aflalo. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. And 11 points for Aaron Aflalo.
Not the biggest fan of that shot, but he had the space to get it off. So why not?
Rondo kicks to Gibson. Vicious to Dunlap. Pass to Rondo.
That's an example there, guys, of contesting the shot and corralling the board. That's really all you can ask of a guy at that end of the floor.
And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two. And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Knicks.
And they've made the long range look like a layup at times in this one, guys.
Well, they've also really been dialed in with their jump shot. I mean, they have not missed much from mid-range today.
No good on that one. And he sinks the second.
They didn't shoot it well from the line in the first half. But they've turned it around here, and it's helped them secure the lead. I mean, free throw shooting is important when you're trying to pad a lead.
Feeds it to Butler. That's good. Butler's got 9 points here in the second half.
and they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range.
Can't happen.
A follow the pass to Porzingis. He dishes it to Rose. The teardrop falls in. Rose has got eight here in the quarter.
Now there's something for the top 10 highlight reel right there. A layup can be just as sweet and as pretty as a dunk sometimes.
And they double up Butler. Back to Rondo. Outside Butler. The pass to Rondo. Corner shot. He clangs that one off the back iron and down it falls. Rondo's got 20 points.
His performance today has just been so important. What a luxury to have a guy that's that dependable.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. Six left in the fourth quarter of this one. Anthony dishes to Noah. It's stolen by Dunleavy. Here's Butler. Kicks it to Rondo. Gets the bucket and the foul. That one on Rose.
How about battling through the impact there and then willing that basketball in?
Boy, it does your heart good to see that kind of determination in a player. Really excellent focus that time.
Shooting so far. A follow with it. Butler covering. A follow kicks to Rose. And here's Anthony for three. And the officials call over the back. A little too aggressive there.
Yeah, not afraid of the physical play, but he still needs to stay under control.
Yeah, he obviously was not under control right there. Not much doubt he was going to get whistled for the over the back call.
The kick out to Rose. To Anthony. Here's the three. And it's Anthony again missing.
Can't get anything to drop. I mean, the way he's going, it's probably not something he should try and shoot his way out of.
Well, they say you should shoot your way out of it, but his teammates probably have other thoughts in mind. The last thing they want to see him doing is continuing to cast that jumper up.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two.
Take a look at what Butler's done. He has 11 points, and from long range, he's hit 1 3-pointer.
And when it's all said and done, I got a sneaky suspicion he's going to have a few more.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a 3-point lead. For them in this ballgame.
No room for mistakes right now. Well, he's building a house with those bricks. I mean, one reason is he keeps trying to force it up when he's defended well. Move the ball, share the sugar.
Rondo with it. Six on the shot clock. Baseline jumper. Buries it.
Really just continuing to increase the lead. This one should be easy for the rest of the way.
Yeah, and you know, Greg, at this late stage, a lead like that, it has a team really feeling quite good about itself, and deservedly so.
Rose passes to a flyer. And nothing is falling for him right now. And an intentional foul right there. Good on the first, and that increases their lead to six. And so he drops them both. It's a 7-point game. Here's Anthony. Can't get it to fall. And so it's Chicago winning this one. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well. I mean, they really did feed off all of that negative energy this crowd was directing at them. I mean, they turned it around and used it as motivation to close out a significant win.
And that'll do it, folks. This is Kevin Harlan saying thank you for tuning in. And now, we present the Jordan Player of the Game, Rajon Rondo.